Mahaska County is considering raising your property taxes because the Federal Emergency Management Agency, or FEMA, has failed to reimburse Mahaska County money it spent on disaster relief.
Mahaska County Emergency Management Coordinator Jamie Robinson says FEMA was expected in October of 2010 to reimburse the county $90,000 in disaster response expenses. The county has yet to receive those funds, and Robinson's office is operating with a negative cash balance.
CRI reporter Patrick Boberg reports the supervisors are considering a tax hike to make up that money.
Paul, Jamie.
With his department virtually broke, Mahaska County Emergency Coordinator Jamie Robinson approached the Mahaska County supervisors last month with a proposal that could potentially keep his office in the black, an adjustment to the property tax levy that partially funds the emergency management office.
Well, basically the way that emergency management gets its funds currently is we do a per capita throughout the county, so everybody pays $1.50 per person.
Now he's looking to change that to a countywide levy, replacing the $1.50 per capita levy with a 10-cent county levy. If it sounds confusing, it's because it is. A per capita tax levy means money is collected based on the population of the taxed area, and each community collects its own tax. In Oskaloosa, a community with roughly 11,000 people, approximately $16,500 is collected by the $1.50 per capita tax, and Oskaloosa is responsible to budget that amount each year and contribute it to the Mahaska Emergency Management budget. Under the 10-cent countywide tax levy, communities are no longer responsible for collecting their individual levies, as tax revenue is assessed on the county level and population is replaced with the most recently assessed taxable land value countywide. So if you own a $100,000 house in Mahaska County, your contribution would be $10, with that amount increasing for every $1,000 of taxable land value. And with $858 million in taxable land value in Mahaska County, the entire county would collectively contribute approximately $85,000 to Mahaska County Emergency Management Office under the most recent property tax assessment figures. The catalyst for this proposal was the failure of the Federal Emergency Management Agency to reimburse the Mahaska office $90,000 for disaster response expenses, money Robinson says was spent on manpower, moving water, and purchasing a boat for several weather-related disasters in the county over the last 3 years.
We've had three presidential declarations in this county in the last couple years, and we just want to make sure that we have the funds and the capabilities of responding to those based off of what's happening, not based off of what we have.
This year, the Emergency Management Office received nearly $30,000 from the $1.50 per capita tax assessment, only one-third of what could be recouped if it switched to the 10-cent countywide tax levy. That increase in tax revenue, coupled with the impending FEMA reimbursement, made County Supervisor Greg Gordy uncomfortable, citing the rising contributions from Mahaska County taxpayers in recent years.
So we had a 50% increase when it went to $1.50 per capita last year. And so it went from $22,000 to $33,000 this year. And then if we jumped to the 10 cents, it jumped to $90,000.
In the end, the Board of Supervisors decided not to vote on the property tax changes, as it felt the proposal needed to include language pertaining to budget funding caps. And they felt the public needed the opportunity to hear about the proposed tax changes. For CRI Weekly News, I'm Patrick Boberg.
The proposed tax increase may change before the county makes a decision. Currently, all of Mahaska County's neighboring counties fund their emergency management offices with countywide tax levies.
The Mahaska County Emergency Management Commission will present its revised proposal to the Board of Supervisors at next Monday's meeting. Board of Supervisors meetings are open to the public. The next meeting is Monday, November 21st at 9 a.m. on the third floor of the Mahaska County Courthouse.